Dr. Stella Emanuel. She is the demon sperm doctor. She's the doctor who gets out there in front of the world and says, you know, to take ivermectin. She's one of them. Now, I don't want to alienate her or isolate her by herself, because there's a whole team of people who are making money off of ivermectin. They're making money off of hydroxychloroquine, and they need these doctors, people crazy enough to go out there on the international stage and say ridiculous stuff like Dr. Stella Emanuel. Well, here's a clip where she's saying that the world leaders are not really human beings, that they're actually clones, and that they're here to drink your blood. This is who is telling you all to not get the vaccine, but to go take ivermectin. Let's run the clip.
Rebecca.
I'm dead ass. I'm serious. Let's watch it.
We have human beings. They call them rulers of darkness of this world, Ephesians 6. These are people that are human beings that are liaising with the devil. But we have spiritual wickedness in high places. These are the clones that are not human. Some of them are governors in states. Some of them are presidents in different countries. Some of them are leaders of places, you know, like all these three letters, CDC, you know, WHO, you know, all this, you know, FDA. Some of them are leaders in those places, and their job is to make laws that will cause people to die.
Yeah.
And you know why? Because they are blood drinkers. They need people to die. They need humanity to die because they need to drink blood.
Okay. See,
go ahead, Rebecca.
Y'all show this lady again, and I tell y'all every time, I'm like, dang. I don't like to do us like that, but at the same time, wrong, and more wrong. This is misinformation. Stop giving it. Now, I told you that we are, when it comes to being misinformed and especially being given information that sounds ridiculous, it's not going to only be down to one race, one culture, one type of people. It's us involved in it too. We sound just as ridiculous as the people that we cover who are white. I told you, everybody is a part of, it doesn't matter who you are. If you're giving misinformation, you're part of the problem. And she definitely is. But so many people will repost it because they do believe a lot of what she's saying. I literally was looking at a friend of mine whom I love since I was a kid, man. Watched her kids, you know, watched her get married. She sings for a major gospel artist right now. Like, so she's very, you know, into the Lord and all that good stuff. But what she took to the internet and was so upset that they were saying, hey, we are now giving vaccines to kids. I think it was, what was the age?
Five to 11. Yeah.
Yes. So Ben, are you, you know, I
damn
know
right.
You're waiting for that. So, okay.
No,
so,
we lined up this week.
Yeah. Okay, great. So, but she was so upset. She said, how could they take my rights from me? She's married to a black man. She's white. And both of them are saying the same thing. Now they both, and I got so upset with both of them because I'm like, you both have really good platforms. We grew up together. I love you guys so much, but you're not going to use, I don't know. It's so funny because they were saying like, oh, the government is trying to take our rights away from us. This is not godly. This is not whatever. And I got so upset because I'm like, here you go, just spinning this thing around. If you don't want to take it, there's one thing, but when you're saying that they're taking your rights away from you, saving lives, is that really taking your rights away from you, or is that allowing you to help other people live? Now, this woman here who says the world leader are clones and she's saying nonsense, but people actually believe this. That's the point I want to get to. People actually will believe this because if they have respect for her, they're going to believe it. And I've seen so many people who have respect for the girl that I'm speaking of, and they just believe. I have respect for this woman, but the fact that she is saying, because there is a vaccine available for kids. Now it's up to you if you want to get your kids vaccinated or not. I get it. But for you to say that, oh my God, my rights are being taken away from us. Let's watch out what our government is doing. You are a part of the ivermectin conversation.
That's the part. They get people that you trust. So when I look at that clip of that sister and Tunde, if you don't mind running the B-roll of her again, because it is the fact, and I understand what bothers you about this, Rebecca, because in a way, this mother represents, some of our elders in our community. But that's why they got her. They got her exactly because they know her aesthetic, her vibe, the way she's dressed, the way she talks. It's just, she got a lot of people who gonna trust her. And that's why they got her.